Welcome back, and that was a beautiful performance by Olakira. Mm-hmm. Hi, Olakira.
I'm good.
First, let's start with your name, and I love the design. That's just so beautiful. Yeah. Where did you get that from?
A friend made it for me.
Okay.
I like that
you're here.
Yeah.
I like. I kind of like that it's not bling. Like it doesn't look very simple. Cliche and kind of has this Afro vibe that.
I don't even know that. It just like something simple.
Yeah. No, it's beautiful. Yeah. So what does Olakira mean?
Shining star.
Wow.
In Swahili. Not in
Nigerian. Swahili.
Yeah, Swahili. Yeah.
So am I guessing the pronunciation right?
Olakira. Yeah, Olakira. Yeah, shining star.
Okay.
It's a unique name. So.
Okay, tell us about you, your sound. Where have you been before? Especially Maserati. Where have you been before that?
The background. I started in church and.
Of course.
From church, no more. Then I went for a recording at the studio because I started writing song. Mm. So I took program on keyboard then in church. Then I went to record official in the studio. So I fell in love with the music production thing. So I went into music production full time. So I wasn't singing for a while, but I write songs. I just drop songs, listen to the song myself. But I've worked with couples of labels. Like the label signed me now, You and I Music, signed Dotman. So I was the in-house producer then. So I write songs, back up for him, do some of his songs that's out there. Mm-hmm. So when his deal ended, I was privileged to,
be signed.
Yeah, be signed. Mm-hmm. So,
so which do you prefer? Being behind the scenes, writing the music and producing it, or now trying to be a popular artist. I mean, behind the scenes, you don't need to be popular, you know. So what's...
I like to use sweet.
Which one is sweet?
This one is sweet.
Yeah. Oh, really? But tell me about it. What's the difference?
Yeah, because before, I didn't really believe in this. Because when they offered me, I said, no. The last... actually, I dropped song. That was about 10 years ago when I dropped the last song. So I don't believe I could still... go into singing professionally. I just want to do my thing, produce and write songs. So because I don't, there's this courage, there's this look, there's this vibe. I'm looking kind of, so I need to up myself and all. So, but right now with the way things, the response, my fan base and all, and it's very interesting. I believe in myself. And I saw some tweets, I saw some comments that made me realize. I like to make people happy through my music. So it's a privilege.
So would you...
I think it was going to be fair to say that music chose you rather than it chose, because you didn't even think that it would be a thing.
It believes in me. Shout out to Ra, So he just said, hey, guy, you can do this.
Did you think Maserati was going to be a hit, though? Because, even for us now,
I think all the songs he sang right now.
Well, Maserati.
Like the last two.
Yeah, Maserati, I feel like, has blown out of proportion incredibly so in comparison to the two of them. Did you think that song, as you were writing it, was going to be what would stand out?
Yeah, I believe, because it's a process. Mm-hmm. Like you said, started from the first song. Mm-hmm. It's like, I know how to write song, I know how to sing, but there's more to this music business. Mm-hmm. So you need to understand a lot of things. Mm-hmm. So within a period of 2 years, or maybe say almost 2 years now, that I got signed, I was able to blend myself. Mm-hmm. I made that beat myself, because I don't have time to wait for one producer to start.
To give you a bit.
Yeah, I know it's not easy to write the song, record the song, produce the song, even mix. I mixed the former song, the one you heard before. Mm-hmm. I mixed the song myself.
Okay, so are you going to... Okay, you write songs.
Yeah.
Have you written songs for any A-list artists?
Mm-hmm.
Let's leave that one. Don't let me
call that. Just tell us. Yes, I just mentioned the name first.
Do you sign the confidentiality thing?
Yeah, it's anything that has to do with that. Yeah, of course, you're right.
You
something similar to that, yeah.
Yeah. So you don't get your credit.
Why is it that? What is the reason behind that? Because we see that changing in other cultures, right? Like in other places, it's actually a proud thing that...
Of course.
It's actually a profession in a profession.
Yeah. So what do you think is the reason why Nigerians wouldn't want you to know that somebody else wrote their song?
We still need to upgrade now. We need to up our tempo. But I can't blame anybody. I'm not... Everybody has their own reason, but I don't think it's mature that way. You should. It's number thing. You don't have to write a song yourself. Sometimes the people are good in delivering.
Yeah.
They're not good in writing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And some people are good in writing. They're not good in delivering. Right.
Yeah. So would you ever let anyone write for you?
That would be very hard.
Mm-hmm.
It was me. I like write. I like.
You're hands-on. Yeah. You want to
like,
do your
thing. What inspired me is beats.
Yeah, that was going to be my question. What inspires you? Where did you get Maserati? I mean, the last guest we had a very interesting story. So, the Maserati story, let's focus on that. Where did that come from?
That one is my love for...
Maserati.
Yeah.
Do you have a Maserati?
Luxury vehicle brand. Don't worry. Actually, I packed one outside.
Hey, let's go.
After telling me, don't worry.
I don't know how to lie.
So, do you have a Maserati?
Is it there's one thing you're adage
in Yoruba. It's just a yes or no.
I think I do.
You're claiming it.
Okay. Akwemora, Maserati, Akwemora.
Okay, what else should we be looking for? We're hoping for the same energy with Maserati, same bangers.
Yeah, the vibe is beautiful.
Should we be looking for that? I mean, things are tough here with COVID and everything, so there's no clubs or concerts. But what can we still kind of like hold on to look out for?
I've got couples of tracks like lined up. You know, right now I'm working on my piano because I produce, I do beat, some of those beats myself. So I've got couples of songs. I need to make, you know, people happy through my sound and everything and to touch lives. Because to be honest with you, somebody said, the way you're making me happy, smiling, listening to your song, I pray you should be happy. Like, I'm like, oh, why? Yeah, I'm like, oh, I'll be happy. Like, it's just amazing for you. So, it's just...
Okay, so one last question before we go, because our time is almost up.
Yeah, I know.
So, when you made the switch between behind the scenes, that's what we call producers and co in this part of the world, and then coming to in front of everybody. Yeah. What's that peculiar thing you noticed that you never saw as a producer in the industry? What is that one thing?
Peculiar thing I noticed and never saw. I like that question. One thing is being, you know, we producers think we can sing like artists. Like, you know, what is there? Just got the song, Joe. You know, but, you know, when I started singing officially, I realized that being an artist is not just... It's not a joke thing, you know. It has to do with a lot of things, and you know, that challenged me a lot. So, but thank God, you know, it's a process, like I said. So,
are you finding it easy? Sorry, I know. Just trying to squeeze in one more. Are you finding it easy? is it networking in that space as an artist, like with other people? Is it a healthy environment? Especially you being a young artist and everything, is it welcoming or is it really toxic? And you just do your music and then go.
It's welcoming. You have to know how to, you know, socialize. That's one thing I have to, you know, because, like you said, producers are always laid back, backstage, you don't want to be on camera. So I have to, but I have those qualities before, but I lost it because I don't do all these things again. Okay. So, but right now, at least I'm talking to you right now.
All right. Thank you for doing tea with us, and that was a beautiful performance.
Pleasure.
We're expecting more beautiful songs from you as well. Don't
trust
move
me.
From Maserati to
something beautiful as you.
Tokumbo. I don't know, but thank you for doing this. And that's how I wrap up this episode of Tea Time. Thank you for watching, and do join the conversation on social media with the hashtag Tea Time or Twitter at @+TVAfrica. My thank you, as always, go to my co-anchors, Ife Omai and Ife Oluwa Shunkeye, who had to step down for social distancing. And of course, our studio guest, Ola Kira. Thank you. And I think I need one of that.
Don't worry.
Okay.
It's a promise.
All right, cool. So you can watch Tea Time on Auto TV and, of course, in London on Ben Television. My name is Elsie Godwin. Please do stay safe.